Welcome to this brief guide on how to generate Google Slides using AI. Google Slides is a common tool for many people to use when creating a presentation, but a lot of us struggle to find the initial draft to at least get our ideas off the ground. So today I'm going to show you how to use AI to make that faster than ever. Here you can see I have some documentation all about Yosemite National Park and the people who rock climb there. Thanks, Wikipedia. But I'd like to put all of this content into a Google Slides presentation. So I'm going to use a tool which is called Magic Slides. You can find this by heading to magicslides.app. I'll include a link in the description below. This application is an add-on for Google Slides, which allows you to customize and even create your Google Slides. We simply click on the button that says Install to get started, and this is going to open up the Google Workspace Marketplace right to the Magic Slides application. Simply click on the button in the corner here that says Install, and this is going to ask you to accept the conditions required for installing. We simply click on Continue, and then it's going to ask us to select our Google account. This is going to tie this extension to your Google account. We click on Allow, and then we just click through here, click Next and Done, and now we can head over to Google Slides to begin working on our presentation. So to create a new slide, I'm just going to head to slides.new. This will create my new slideshow for me. And then in order to utilize the extension, I simply head up to my toolbar and I'm going to select the option that says Extensions. Selecting Extensions, you'll see that we now have the Magic Slides app extension there, and we're going to select the option that says Open. It'll take a couple of moments while it works, and it'll open up a sidebar that you can utilize, and I've got it highlighted over here, and you'll see a few different options available to us. The first of which is to summarize. So if you already have some existing content and you'd like this to summarize it for your slide presentation, you can do so there. The text option is the one we're going to use, which is to generate an entire slide deck for us. And then color and font is just if you want to update the look of your presentation to a more stylish design, such as either vintage rose or even midnight sun. We'll head back to text, and now we need to enter in the topic and information for our slide presentation. I'm going to call mine Rock Climbing in Yosemite National Park. And now that I've got my topic entered, we want to head down to the reference text section. This is optional, but this is where you can insert any particular text that you would like the AI to use as a basis for its slide generation. So I'm going to copy all of that information that I have gotten from Wikipedia, and I'm going to paste it into the reference text box. Now that I've got that inserted, we want to head down to the next box, which is our instructions. This is also optional, but this allows us to include some additional instructions for the AI, such as in my case here, including images and references. You then have your option for your total number of slides, but please note this is the maximum number of slides. It could potentially result in less slides being available. And then we have the option to replace any of the existing slides, such as that blank one I currently have. And we also have the option to dictate whether or not there will be requirements for there to be an image on every slide. Once done, we can hit the generate button, but it's worth noting that you do have 3 credits per month for free. You can have the option of upgrading to the Pro or Premium account, but if you create the odd presentation per month, this can be more than fine on the free account. Then we select the generate button, and this will begin the generation process. You'll notice that it does say 100 seconds by default. However, this is the maximum number of time it will take. In my particular case, generating this particular slide presentation only took around about 30 minutes. And there's my presentation created. I have the option to rate the presentation as well, which gives the AI some feedback whether or not it did a good or bad job. Here, as you can see, is now my deck. I've got a quick title slide, and I've got a few slides that contain the information that I had inserted via my reference text, as well as some images, and they are referenced as far as where they've come from as well. We've got a few different things that cover the different topics that I would like to potentially talk about. But what you'll notice is maybe some of these photos aren't quite right, or maybe the layout's a little bit off, but at least this gives me a great starting point. And if I wanted to replace any of these images, I could simply select the image and use the replace image button here in the toolbar. Or I can right click, and I'll also have the option to replace image in the context menu. And then I can quickly and easily either upload from either my own computer or maybe even search Google Images to be able to quickly replace those photos and update my slide deck accordingly. Now, just like anything else that's created via generative AI, I'm going to recommend that you always double check your information and ensure that it is accurate before moving ahead with the content that has been created. And that is how you use the power of generative AI to help you create Google Slides. I hope you found this tip extremely useful and it saves you plenty of time in the future. And I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel. And if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.